Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Engineering Network and welcome to a new video of Etabs 2016 tutorial. In this particular training program, we are analyzing and designing 5-story residential building and today we will do multiple things. First, I'll be showing you how to assign dead load and live load and wall loads to a model. And also we will learn about various methods of meshing on slab section. So before we start this very important video, if you are new here and haven't subscribed to my channel yet, then please subscribe and also click on this small bell icon so that you will get notified when I publish a new video. So without wasting your time, let's get started. Okay, so let's first start with assigning the live loads to my model. So for that, click on select and then again select and here look for object type option and click on it. Now in this window, I will select the floors and then click on select. Okay, so as you can see that all the floors in my model have been selected. But the live load will not act on the roof and on the staircase room. Only dead load will act there. So I don't need to assign any live load on the roof and staircase roof. So what I will do here is to deselect the roof and the staircase room roof. For that, again click on select, then click on deselect and here look for stories option. Because I want to deselect a particular stories. Okay, so here click on stories and in this window select the particular story that you want to deselect, which is roof and staircase room. So select both these stories and then click on deselect and you will notice that the roof and staircase room have been deselected. Now I want to assign the live load. So as you know that this is a 5-story residential building and as per ACI 31804 and UBC 97 codes, the live load for a residential building is 40 pound per square feet. So here I will assign a live load of 40 pound per square feet. For that, click on assign and then select shell load because it is a slab and then click on uniform here. So in this window here select live and the load is 40 pound per square feet. So type 40 and the direction should be gravity because this load will act downward. So keep this as gravity and then click on OK. So as you can see clearly that the live load of 40 pound per square feet have been assigned. Next is we will assign the dead load. So before assigning the dead load, I would like to select similar story from the story option. It is because the slabs have been defined on all similar stories. Next, we have to calculate the dead load for that particular model. So as you already know that the thickness of slab in this particular model is 5 inches, okay? So the slab will have its own self weight and also we will do finishing to the floor as well, which consists of 6 inch of mud layer and 1 inch PCC layer. So now let's calculate the dead load. So here to find out the self weight of the slab, we will divide this 5 inches, which is the thickness of the slab, by 12 to convert it to feet, because here the units is in feet, and then multiply it with the unit weight of concrete, which is 150 pound per square feet, and we will get the self weight of the slab, which is 62.5 pound per square feet. Then similarly, the dead load of 6 inch mud layer will be 6 divided by 12 to convert it to feet, then multiply it with the unit weight of mud layer, which is 110 pound per square feet, and we will get the dead load of 6 inch mud layer, which is 55 pound per square feet, and at last calculate the dead load of 1 inch PCC layer as well. So now add all these dead loads and the total dead load that will be acting on this particular building will be 130 pound per square feet. So after calculating the dead load, we will select the floors on which we want to assign the dead load and the dead load will be acting on all the floors of the building. So for that, again click on select, then again select and then click on object type. And here select floors because the dead load will be acting on all the floors. So as you can see that all the floors have been selected. So to assign dead load of 130 pound per square feet, go to assign, then shell load, and here click on uniform. Now in this window, select here dead load and here type 130, and its direction will also be gravity. So click on OK. As you can see now, the dead load is also been assigned. Okay, so the live load and dead load have been assigned. Next is I have to assign the wall load. In the case of wall load, there are two ways to assign the wall load in Etabs 2016. First is by using the draw hole option, and the second one is to assign the wall load as uniformly distributed load on the desired frame line. And here I would like to prefer the second option, because you can assign the desired wall load as UDL, and it is much more flexible option. So to assign the wall load, first we have to define the load pattern for wall load. For that, click on define and then select load pattern, and in this window, as you can see, the dead load and live load pattern has been defined by default. So to define the wall load pattern, here type its name, which is masonry, because walls will be constructed with masonry. Then in type select super dead and leave the self weight multiplier as 0. And after making all these changes, click on add new load. So now as you can see, a new load pattern have been assigned for wall load, and then click on OK. Next is we have to select the frame lines where we want to assign the masonry load. So for that, click on select and again select, and click on object option, and here in this window select beams, because the masonry or wall load will directly act on the beams. So here we will assign the wall load on the beams, and as you can see, all the beams have been selected. Now you have to look for one thing here. If you look at the model, the walls will be constructed from the ground floor up to the fifth story, and there will be no walls on the roof and on the roof of staircase room. So the wall load will not act on the roof and on the staircase roof. But here if you look closely, the beams of the roof and also the staircase roof beams are selected, and we have to deselect these beams. So again go to select, then deselect, and here click on stories, and in this window select roof and staircase room, and then click on deselect. As you can see now, the roof and staircase beams have been deselected, but I will select few beams on the roof on which the staircase room is acting, and those beams are this one, this one, this one, and last this one. So all the beams have been selected on which wall load will be acting. Now we will assign the masonry load. So go to assign, then frame loads, and select the distributed loads. And in this window, change the name of the load pattern to masonry, and the masonry load that will act on these beams will be 15 pound per square feet, which I have calculated manually. So here type 15 and then click on apply and OK. So here as you can see that the wall load has been applied on all the selected beams. Next is we will talk about various methods of meshing of slab section. Here in this model I have assigned my floor slabs as membrane type. So when you assign your slab with membrane property, whatever load you apply on the slab is transferred to the surrounding beams. In the case of membrane slab, especially in the case of irregular shape, it is a good practice to shell the slab so that the load distribution will be more accurate. In Etabs 2016, there are two ways that you can use to mesh the slab. One is the manual meshing and the second one is the automatic meshing. First I would like to explain the manual meshing. So here I would like to select this slab which I want to mesh manually, and after making the selection, go to edit and then select edit shell, and then go to divide shell. Here in this window, select the third option, which is divide quadrilateral triangles into. And here I want to mesh my selected slabs in 12 by 12 areas, which means that the selected slave will be divided into 12 parts in x direction and 12 parts in y direction. So here type 12 by 12 and then OK. So now as you can see that the selected slave has been meshed in 12 by 12 areas. So here if you want to see the distribution of loads, go to display, then load assigns, and then select shell and then apply. So here as you can see that the dead load of 130 pound per square feet has been assigned to each meshed area. Next I would like to explain the automatic meshing. The automatic meshing is very helpful in the case of irregular slabs, because in this irregular slab here it is not possible to go for manual meshing. So I have to go for automatic meshing for these three irregular slabs. So first I would like to select this slab, then go to assign and then shell, and here select the floor auto mesh option, and in this dialog box option select the fourth option, which is mesh object into. So here I want to mesh the selected slab in 12 areas. So type 12 by 12 and click on OK. So now as you can see that the selected irregular slab have been meshed into 12 by 12 areas. Similarly, you can do the automatic meshings for the remaining two irregular shapes, and you can also do the manual meshing for the other adjacent slabs also. So here as you can see now I have meshed my all the floor slabs and all the balcony slabs as well using the automatic meshing method. So this is how you can assign the dead load, live load and the wall loads to a model and also meshing the slabs. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you would like it. If yes, then please click on the like button, share it with your friends, and if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, then please click on the subscribe button, and also don't forget to click on the small bell icon, because it will help you to get notified on time when I publish a new video. So goodbye, see you in next video. Thank you.